الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا، صدق الله العظيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. دوري شيط الله. Respected brothers, respected elders, mothers and sisters listening at home, we have been covering the history of Masjid Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first extension of Masjid Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was during the lifetime of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the year 7 Hijri. Brothers will remember there was empty land neighboring Masjid Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam belonging to one Ansari Sahabi. It was Hazrat Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu who paid for that land and gave that land as waqf to Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Abu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then included that area into the masjid. That was the very first extension after the completion of Masjid Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then we come to the Khilafat of Sayyidina Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala. After the demise of Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala had a grand responsibility on his shoulders. Just imagine for 1 minute, my respected brothers, Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has passed away. The love that the companions have for Huzur alayhi salatu wa sallam. Hazrat Zayd radiyallahu ta'ala an, the one who in his vision was shown the words of the Adhan, the Kalimat of Adhan. He was far away from Madinatul Munawwara. When he heard of Huzur alayhi salatu wa sallam's death, Abu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ka intiqal hua, straight away he lifted up his hands and says, Ya Allah, there is no benefit now of these eyes. These eyes were only useful when they could see Huzur alayhi salatu wa sallam's face. I'd rather be blind. And with such ikhlas he made that dua, because he was mustajabud da'wat. He was from those companions that any time, whenever he lifted up his hand, Allah would accept his dua. Any time. He was mustajab al-dawah. Not realizing of that deep love that they had. SubhanAllah. And everyone was affected by this. Everyone. All the companions except for Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu. He played a fundamental role after the demise of Huzur alayhi salatu wa sallam. And he became blind. It is said only during the time of salat, when the muazzin would give azan, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would give him sight back, he would come to the masjid, and slowly after namaz, the sight would go away again. SubhanAllah. This was the dua. Huzur alayhi salatu wa sallam's dua. Huzur alayhi salam's dua is accepted. Sahaba-i kiram ajma'in's dua is also accepted. The dua of a believer is also accepted. Hazrat Abu Tufail Amri radiyallahu ta'ala, who was the leader of one of the Arab tribes, he came to Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam, met him and embraced Islam on the hands of Huzur alayhi salam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I am going to go back to my tribe, the Arabs. I also want all of them to become Muslim. I am the leader of the tribe. I am a Muslim. I want all of them to become Muslim. When I go back, they will ask me for one sign, something that will prove that you are the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam lifted up his hands and said, Ya Allah, illuminate his face. Iske chehre ko munawwar kar do. Illuminate his face. Translation, Angrezi. It is said that in between his two eyes there was a light shining. In between his two eyes, a light was shining. And again, that did not in any way lessen his beauty, subhanAllah, but only increased the beauty that was with him. And with the light it increased. And when he went back to his tribe, he said, this is the mu'jiza of Huzur alayhi salatu wasalam. And every single one of them became a Muslim. Ya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ki zaati akhlas. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq played a fundamental role. No one in Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at that time could take control of Hazrat Umar Farooq. Everyone became quiet. Hazrat Umar Farooq was there with his sword. Whenever he went, he took his sword out. Anybody who tells me that Abu Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has passed away, he has to deal with me first. All the companions were quiet in the masjid. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an at that time was outside of Madinatul Munawwara. One of his wives was living on the outskirts of Madinatul Munawwara. He had taken permission to go and visit her. As he went there, someone came on the outskirts of Madinatul Munawwara to tell him what has happened. When he left Huzur alayhi salatu wasalam, Abu Sallallahu alayhi wasallam was stable. And that is why Huzur alayhi salam said to him that you can go and visit your family that is outside Medina. And when he came back, he saw Hazrat Umar Farooq in this trance. It was only Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala who got hold of Hazrat Umar Farooq and told him to sit down. And he recited the words, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ. Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam was the mighty messenger of Allah. قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. So many messengers came. Ibrahim Khalilullah, Musa Kalimullah, great prophets came. أَفَإِنْ مَاتَ أَوْ قُتِلَ انْقَلَبْتُمْ عَلَىٰ أَعْقَابِكُمْ وَمَنْ يَنْقَلِبْ عَلَىٰ عَقِبَيْهِ فَلَنْ يَدُرُ اللَّهَ شَيْئًا وَسَيَجْزِي اللَّهُ الشَّاكِرِينَ. He stood up on the minbar, and that is the one ayat that he read in front of the companions. And all the companions then settled down. They understood and they knew the meaning of this ayat-i-kareemah. So after the demise of Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam, all the responsibility fell on his shoulders. He had to take care of the munafiqeen that were there with the other Arab tribes who were trying to take advantage of the death of Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam and wanted to dismantle the strength of Islam. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq was there right at the forefront making jihad with them. Anyone who did inkar, who refused to pay the tax or zakat, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala dispatched a group of people to make jihad with them. He had a lot of responsibility. He had to deal with the munafiqeen, the munkirine zakat. But with all the responsibility, the mu'arrikheen say, yet he did khidmat of the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is why anyone who is connected to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he should count himself fortunate. But Allah has selected him, Allah has chosen him. Allah has chosen him to clean the masjid, to clean the toilet, to have this natural love for the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a ni'mah, my respected brother. People go out Friday night, Saturday night. They go out to town. Nojawan log kahan kahan jaate. Young Muslim boys are out there in the clubs doing everything that is wrong. And then you get the other youth that fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After Isha they go to sleep with the intention that inshallah they have to wake up for Fajr Salah. Isn't that the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It is said that Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq's khidmat was that he rebuilt the pillars of Masjid-e-Nabwi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that had become old. In the Khilafat of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq, he took the responsibility. All the pillars that were there, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala rebuilt them all. After the death of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, who is the second Khalifa, bhai? Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala. What a man he was. Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala and his plan and planning was something at a much wider scale. The extension was also massive. He extended the masjid from all the sides except for the eastern block of Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That was untouched. The eastern block. The eastern block, brothers who have visited Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the eastern block of Masjid Nabi is where the rooms of the Azwaj Mutahharat are, where Bibi Fatima's room is, where it connects slowly from the Hujra, the chamber of Hazrat Fatima, to Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam's room. That is the eastern block. The extension again was very, very big. He even increased the height of the ceiling of Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he added extra doors to Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala who added the door from the western side, but the door was fixed on the southern block of Masjid Nabi, and that door was known as Babu Salam. Kaun salam tha? Babu Salam. What a beautiful name. Isn't it a beautiful name? Babu Salam. Subhanallah. Salamati ka darwaza. Ka darwaza? Salamati. And two extra doors towards the eastern block that was only exclusively reserved for women. For women to go in and for women to go out. Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala was extra careful when it came to parda. Women were completely separate from the entrance, the area, the musalla, the prayer hall was completely different, the exit, entry, everything was different. This was done in the time of Hazrat Umar Farooq. Also the ulama say the entire wall of Masjid Nabawi was replastered. In the time of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq and Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam, kachi inte thi, unbaked brick. But in the time of Hazrat Umar Farooq, the plaster, again the material was a bit strong. The plaster was strong. Proper bricks were used to strengthen the walls of Masjid Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One other khidmat that Hazrat Umar Farooq did was he built one chamber which was known as Baqiha. What is it known as? Baqiha. That was on the southern block of Masjid Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Outside of the masjid, one big room that was known as Baqiha. Hazrat Umar Farooq was extra sensitive when it came to people talking in the masjid. He disliked that. Anyone he saw talking, he personally dealt with them. Hamara kya hal hota agar Hazrat Umar Farooq kya hote? Sabki gardan chali jati. Hazrat Umar Farooq, subhanallah, kaisi shaan. He wanted silence in the masjid, absolutely silent. You pray, you do the tilawat, you do the zikr of Allah, but no talking, no conversation. And he made this special room. He said to the musallis that were there, the companions, that if anyone needed to talk, then he should go to the Baqiha, to the chamber that Hazrat Umar Farooq made, he built there. He says, go outside and talk there. I said, Captain, if you want to talk, then go downstairs and talk. Hazrat Umar Farooq would do the same thing. He says, go outside Masjid Nabawi and go inside the Baqiha in that room and talk whatever you want. See, some of the companions, if they had to discuss some matters, subhanAllah, like you have the houses of parliament here, where everything is negotiated. The parliament house, the main area where everything, all the mashwira would take place, was Masjid Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If the companions needed to talk, they would go into the Baqiha and talk there. But there was absolutely silence in the masjid. This khidmat was done by Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala. After the death of Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala an, came the Khilafat of Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an. Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an, again, a grand Sahabi of Huzur alayhi salam. With Hazrat Uthman, the difference was that he himself personally was a very wealthy man. Very, very wealthy man. I don't know if brothers were here in Jummah. The wealth of Hazrat Abdul Rahman bin Auf, they say when he passed away, the companions had to use the shovel to move the gold from one area to another area. They say that they got blisters in their hands. Kitni daulat hogi? And he is from the Ashray Mubashara, those given glad tidings of Jannah. Imagine so much wealth, but a grand sahaba. That is why, my respected brothers, we should not attack the rich people. Oh, maldar aadmi takabbur hoga, no, koi zaruri nahi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who judges. Possibly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them the tawfiq. If Allah has given them wealth, they give charity. They give charity, they are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the examples are this. Hazrat Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala was a very rich Sahabi as compared to Hazrat Umar Farooq radiyallahu ta'ala. Hazrat Umar Farooq didn't have anything. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala in the early days, he was a businessman, he had a lot of wealth. But Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq was of the aqeedah that nothing should be in the house. That is his aqeedah. Nothing should be in the house. So anything that came, charity. Anything that came, charity. Anything that came to Huzur alayhi salatu wasalam. Nothing was there for him in the house. SubhanAllah. Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala, he was a businessman. He had a lot of wealth. His extension was so massive. So massive. Much more covering than what Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq did and whatever Hazrat Umar Farooq did. He extended the masjid from the northern side, from the southern side, and from the western side. All the extension was done. And for the first time ever, the difference was that he even pushed the wall of Qibla one saf forward. One saf forward. None of the companions did that. They pushed the Qibla wall one saf forward, and for the first time, steel, loha, hadid, steel was used, and they were put inside the pillars of Masjid Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A complete reconstruction of Masjid Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with beautiful stones, different stones were used to beautify Masjid Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also the mihrab, the section of mihrab was completely different. The mihrab had windows. The mihrab had, so he could see everything that was outside, whatever, however it was at that time. He could see things from the inside, outside of Masjid Nabawi, and those who were outside, they could see Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. The reason for that is the companions gave him mashwira for precautionary measure. Hazrat Umar Farooq was assassinated when the enemy was hiding behind the mihrab. Behind the minbar and behind the mihrab. He came out, it was dark, with a sword, and he attacked Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala. So for security reasons, the companions said that they made mashwara that no, it should be, the mihrab should be in such a way that you can see who is on the outside of the mihrab. This was something different. And there is also a picture of it here. Anyone who wants to see the mihrab of Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala, even the Saudi government have not extended the Qibla wall. So where the Imam of Masjid Nabawi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stands today, and when he reads, when he does Imamat of Salat, that is the exact wall which was extended by Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. So even the Saudi government's extension is all at the back, not much towards the eastern block, much more towards the southern, the western, and the northern block. And the Qibla wall remains the same borderline which Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala had built in his time. That is why in the time of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this was the Qibla. This was the Qibla. Qibla yet. During the time of the Khilafat of Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala, the Qibla wall was extended one row forward. One row forward. Brothers who go to make ziyarat of Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will know that it is in that area a line, a group of people go towards that. There is a passage there that when you enter, you exit that area, the eastern block of it, and that wall is the Qibla which was done by Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. The ulama say that he himself personally was supervising everything. It is said that sometimes he would even sleep in the masjid to make sure that everything in Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is perfect. The ulama say that majority of everything that was spent in Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was with the money of Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala only. Subhanallah. That is why, my respected brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you wealth. Spend in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Spend. The more you give, the more Allah gives you. The more you give, the more Allah gives you. And that is the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never fear poverty. The shaytanu ya'idukumul faqr. The shaytan puts in your heart that everything will, all your wealth will go away from you. No, Allah give in the right place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you much more. This was during the Khilafat of Sayyidina Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala and Alhamdulillah, after the construction of Masjid, extension of Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a few days later, Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala and was made shaheed. Allahu Akbar. Khulafai Kiram Azmain ki tarteeb dekhi. Besides Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq, Hazrat Umar Farooq, shaheed. Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala, shaheed. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, also shaheed. All the three khulafa, shaheed. When Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala came to the Khilafat, he did not have any need to extend anything of Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because the extension was fresh, complete during the time of Sayyidina Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. And so he didn't do anything of the extension. After the period of Khulafa'i Kiram Ajma'in, then came the time of Walid bin Abdul Malik, and he had appointed Hazrat Umar bin Abdul Aziz radiallahu ta'ala as the Amir of Madinatul Munawwara, a great Buzrug. Hazrat Umar bin Abdul Aziz was known as Umar the Second. Umar the Second. One was Umar ibn al-Khattab, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala, and the second was known as Hazrat Umar ibn al-Aziz. And he was the Amir of Madinatul Munawwara. He took the responsibility again of the extension of Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This extension was a bit different from the extension of the Khulafa'i Kiram Ajma'in. Now, for 1 minute, if brothers can imagine, this is the eastern block of Masjid Nabi. This is where salam is given to Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam. So you enter from this side and you exit here. This is the rooms of the Hujra where Hazrat Fatima radiallahu ta'ala and Hazrat Aisha and all the chambers are. This side is the southern block and this side is the western block. All the time the extension was concentrated on this area, for this area, for this area. Because of the Qibla wall, much extension was not done here, only during the time of Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. And the minbar of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was right close to the room of Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. The difference between this extension and the extension of the Khulafa was that Hazrat Umar bin Abdul Aziz radiallahu ta'ala also extended the masjid from the eastern block to make it a complete square. That's the name? To make it a complete square. Why he extended the masjid from the eastern block? Because the Khulafa didn't attend that, because at that time the wives of Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam their chambers were on the eastern block of the masjid. And because of their chambers, because of their rooms, they did not extend the rooms into the masjid. But later on, when the Khilafat of Walid bin Abdul Malik came, obviously it was a long time after that, Azwaj Mutahharat radiallahu ta'ala anhum, they all passed away, and Hazrat Umar bin Abdul Aziz radiallahu ta'ala anhum paid the price of all the chambers and gave the money to the warasa, the inheritors, and that those rooms were also included inside the masjid. Nothing was done about it. The room stayed like how it was during the time of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but the only, the extension took place towards the eastern block. And for the first time in the Khilafat of Hazrat Umar bin Abdul Aziz, the Muslimin used gold, pure gold, to beautify Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Gold was used on the ceiling and gold was used on the pillars of the masjid. This was done during the time of Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala, Sayyidina Umar bin Abdul Aziz radiallahu ta'ala. Also marble, beautiful marble, different colorful stones were brought into Masjid Madinatul Munawwara for the building of Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The ulama say the difference in this extension was that first time ever in Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, minarets were built also. So on the four corners of Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you had four minarets. How many minarets are there today? Eight? You think so? That's a good guess, huh? MashaAllah. We have a lot of minarets today in Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the extension again is absolutely beautiful. SubhanAllah. Malik Fahad, just the share, the reward, inshaAllah ta'ala, if Allah will. But during the time of Sayyidina Umar bin Abdul Aziz, the four minarets. And subhanAllah, the hikmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the history from the time of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam until today, it is said that Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam caught fire twice. Aag lagi masjid mein. Kitni martaba? Do martaba. Once was when the Khadim of Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whose name was Abu Bakr bin Awhad, he would stay and spend the night in the masjid. His duty was to, he had this candle in his hand and there was a lamp inside the minaret, and in the night he would light the lamp, so there was light coming out in the minaret. Once what happened is that when he had the candle, it was a big candle, accidentally that candle fell down from his hand, and subhanAllah, by then there was rugs in the masjid and there was material also around. That caught fire and Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at that time was burning. This was the English day, the year 1256. Consider the year 1256. All the people of Madinatul Munawwara came outside to extinguish the fire, subhanAllah. But the fire did not come close to the hujra of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The main section was all intact. It was only the extension area that was completely burnt out. And the second fire is connected to the minaret. I said to our Ibrahim Bhai, I said, when we come for Fajr, I see that there's light coming out from two of the minarets, but there's no light in the two minarets here. Inshallah, Ibrahim Bhai, again, he's a great Khadim of the masjid. Allah give him Jazayah Khair. SubhanAllah, he serves the masjid, he works hard. In fact, the entire team has contributed in the building of this masjid. There are two lights are not working. I was talking to him, I said, in the time after when Masjid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was built, in the history, the ulama say, the masjid was only burnt twice. One was with the candle of Abu Bakr bin Awhad, and the second time was with the natural lightning that hit the minaret and the minaret caught fire. The lightning hit the minaret and the minaret caught fire. And that fire was a blazing fire. Allahu Akbar. It is said that the Sadr Muazzin, the head Muazzin, Sheikh, SubhanAllah, Sheikh Shihabuddin bin Khatib, Sheikh Shihabuddin bin Khatib, he was the Sadr Muazzin at that time, he died in this fire. Wo kya ho gaye the? Shaheed ho gaye the. And the fire came this time, it burnt everything, including also the minbar and the mihrab. Everything was burnt down, subhanAllah. This is the wish of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam has said that fire is your enemy. Fire is your enemy. Shaitan is made out of fire. Inna shaitan lakum aduvun. Shaitan is your enemy. Shaitan is your enemy. Shaitan is made out of fire. And fire is also your enemy. So make sure when you are sleeping in the night, anything that is flammable, look up, make sure the gas, everything is shut off. Even the boiler and everything. A lot of the people leave it on. It is up to the individual. The hukam of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is that all the fire, anything, all the flames should be extinguished. This is the hukam of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. SubhanAllah. And after that, alhamdulillah, until today, there is security and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep it that way. Allahumma ahfazil haramayn sharifayn. InshaAllah ta'ala, there is much more to it. Perhaps maybe in the next session we can touch on the minbar of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the present minbar and the minbars built by the different kings, and also the pillars, and also the dome, and the mihrab, and the carpet, and the garden, the Rawdatul Min Riyad al-Jannah. If Allah wills, inshallah, we will continue with this subject in the next session of Jumu'ah. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Jazakallah khair. اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وسلم تسليما الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدنيا والآخرة اللهم إنا نسألك من رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من غضبك والنار وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وذرياته وأهل بيته أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين